Cold War eye, a brutal and seemingly endless stalemate, finally met its dramatic end in 1918. But the war's conclusion was a sudden event. It was a complex tapestry woven from military collapse, internal strife, and shifting global power dynamics.
Do you also want to be a content creator but don't know how to create amazing content on YouTube? Or don't know how to use AI to create videos or voiceover for your videos? Or you are shy to speak yourself? So this video is for you. Today we're going to learn how to create end-to-end AI generated video with a simple and easy approach, where we would be taking the script using AI, we are going to generate image using AI, and we are going to create a audio using AI. Okay, so let's head towards the ChatGPT and let's begin. So make sure you're already logged in with your account in ChatGPT. So here we are in ChatGPT. I'll simply paste my prompt here. I'll put this prompt in the description as well. Prompt is very simple. We are just asking ChatGPT to be our video script writer, a professional script writer and a creative director, and compose a couple of scenes for us on the given topic. And we have defined the structure here. The output must be in a tabular structure divided in scenes. And what exactly we want a dialogue and an image prompt. Dialogue is going to be used in the AI voice generator, and image prompt is going to be used in AI image generator. So let's give it a topic. Let's say history of World War One. You can just give any topic to ChatGPT. You can research your topics, and based on your given topic, ChatGPT will generate a nice script for us. So let's hit the send button and let's wait a couple of minutes while it generates the entire script for us. And we also mentioned that, you know, don't include any extra text or explanations. I just want the story. And this is the time you have to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon if you haven't done it. So we already have our dialogues and image prompt ready. And now I'll tell you what exactly we have to use to create the audio. And this is another very cool tool which you can use to create text to speech, which you can use to create voice cloning, and you can create a speech to text as well, where you can upload an audio and it will create a text or a transcribe your audio to a text. So we are going to use text to speech. Voice cloning is something where you can record your voice and it will clone your voice as it is. So one time you have to create this activity, clone your voice, and then you will be getting an audio which speaks like you, like your voice. So this is the possibility here. And in free version of the tool is FishAudio, fish.audio. You will get a link of the FishAudio in my description below. And this tool allows you to create up to 1 hour of video every month for free. And if you want to explore the plans, you can just go ahead and explore the plans. Plans are also affordable. You can see it is almost half of the price of the other competitors in the market, and it has really crystal clear and natural sounding voice which FishAudio generates. And it also has APIs as well, where you can automate the end-to-end video generation pipeline, but that is not today's topic anyways. So yeah, here we are in FishAudio, and you can just simply, you know, listen to the audio which they have here.
So the key to effective noise reduction is understanding signal processing at a fundamental level. We're basically teaching AI to distinguish between what humans want to hear and what they do. It's like teaching your computer
okay,
to be
okay,
so really
good. I'll just log in with my Google account here. So here we are logged in with our Google account, and you can see I got 20 playgrounds here. So when you go to the discovery tab, you can see all the models here. You can filter the models, you can search the models, you can filter them based on the languages. You can see recommended or the newest models first, and you can listen to the models. You can share or copy the link with you if you want to use them. You can just click on the use. So let's use something here which sounds good. So let me just play something.
Hey there. After months of intensive development, FishAudio 1.5 has...
This sounds good, and let's see how this horror sounds.
During the winter of 1985...
I feel this is a good audio for the topic which we have selected today. So I'll just simply click on use. It will take me to the playground where I can paste my script. So we are going to paste the script here which we generated. So you can just, you know, copy the dialogues from here and paste them here. You can make it one by one, or you can paste your entire dialogues here. And here we already selected the voice. You can change the voices from here. These are all the settings for the voices. If you opt for the premium version of the FishAudio, you can adjust more settings and you can customize the voice which you have here. Like, you can customize the volume, speed, temperature, and a couple of items here. So let's just click on the generate and play, and it will ask you, do you want a premium version, do you want a pro version, but we are going to go with a free plan for now. So let's go with the free tier, and this is what giving it to me. I get 20 quota, and which is going to be resetted on this date next month. Okay, this is good. Just select the free and hit generate and play again. Let it generate the voiceover.
World War I, also known as the Great War, erupted in 1914, dragging millions into a conflict unlike anything the world had seen before.
You can see the voiceover has been generated, so I'll just download this file which we would be using in our video editing process. And today we are not going to cover how to edit the video. That is a simple process. You can use any video editing tools like DaVinci Resolve or VN Edits or CapCut or any tool which you like, Premiere Pro, whatever you like. You can just simply drag in the audio, drag in the image, and just render out the video. Okay, so it's time to generate an image now. So we are going to copy the image prompt. You can use again multiple different tools to generate the images. We can go for the Gemini, you can go for the ChatGPT, as we already see in ChatGPT capabilities. We can ask ChatGPT to generate an image, but if you want, you can explore Gemini as well. Let's try with the ChatGPT and Gemini, both of them, you know, who generates a better image. So let's say, hello, generate an image for, and then let it generate the image. Okay, lots of people are doing this, so this might take a bit. No worries, it will take some time, but once our image is ready, we'll be seeing it here. Meanwhile, we can ask Gemini as well. So I'm just opening Gemini. Gemini is generating image for us, and there are lots of other tools which provides you the APIs to generate images. You can, if your machine is strong enough, you can set up a local image generation environment in your machine as well. Now you can see Gemini has generated the image. You can use these images, and you can use the audio which we are generated using FishAudio, and you can combine them together. So as you have this entire script here, you just have to go one by one for each dialogue and for each image, combine everything together, and your video is ready. If you want to record yourself a tutorial video, you can just capture the screen. Or if you want to create an informational video but you don't want to use your voice as it is, you can just use FishAudio to generate a voice clone of your voice, or you can use any other available voices here from their library. So yes, I hope you have enjoyed this video. Till the next video, keep watching, keep learning, keep designing. And I don't think ChatGPT has yet generated the image, but anyways, just subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon next to it, because if you're not doing that, then you're going to miss a lot of exciting notifications for all our future uploads. And don't forget to let me know in the comments if you want to learn anything specific regarding generative AI, video editing, or our UI UX things.